So good morning students. Today we'll discuss how to solve job assignment problem using branch and bound technique. So first we'll see the problem definition. Given n jobs and there are n people to do the jobs, we need to assign the jobs to each of the person in such a way that the cost of the assignment should be minimized. So here they given the matrix. This matrix is called as cost adjacency matrix, and the cell in the matrix, the value in the matrix represent the cost associated with that job to that person. For example, here job J1, if person want to do the job 1, person A want to do the job 1, he is going to quote 9 rupees. If you consider these in terms of rupees, then this will be 9 rupees. If person C want to do job J4, he is going to quote 8 rupees. If person D want to do job J2, he is going to quote 6 rupees. See, here one assumption is all the 4 persons are able to do all 4 jobs, but we need to assign the jobs to each of the person in such a way that only one job is to be assigned to the person, one person, and the cost should be minimized. So this is the problem of the minimization. So here this matrix is a cost adjacency matrix. So we'll try to solve this by using branch and bound technique. Again, you are going to build a state space tree for this, and you are going to calculate lower bound value. In just previous class, you have seen for the knapsack problem, we calculated upper bound, but here, as this problem is associated with the minimization problem, we are going to calculate lower bound value for each of the there is node in the state space tree. So we'll start drawing the state tree for this job assignment problem. So it is the start node, node number 0. Node number 0, I start here, and we need to calculate lower bound value, LB value. So for the root node, lower bound value is to be calculated by tracing each of the row, finding the smallest element of each of the row, and performing the sum at the end. Right. So here, lower bound value in the first row. If you trace the first row, the smallest value is 2. Third row and fourth row, if you trace, this value is 4. So these 4 elements you need to add up, that will become the lower bound for the root level node. So a root level node is the starting node. Here we are not allocating any jobs to any person. Just we are tracing the row, finding out the smallest element and performing the sum of those elements. So here so LB value is equal to 10. I'll write the values here. 2 plus 3 plus 1 plus 4 equal to 10. 10 is the lower bound value for node number 0. Next, we need to explore this node, write all the possibilities for the next level. So there will be 4 options or possibilities. So we'll write, so write 4 nodes in the next level. So when for person A, job J1 is assigned, what is the lower bound value we need to calculate? That is the first, that is the node written here. Next node is when J2 job is assigned for person A, what is the lower bound value that we need to calculate and write it here. Then for the same person, person A, when job J3 is assigned, what is the lower bound value that we'll calculate and write it in the third node. And for the fourth node, when job J4 is assigned to person A, what is the lower bound value that we'll calculate and write in these four nodes. So for person A, say when job J1 is assigned. For person B, when J2 is assigned. Job J. Lower bound values. So lower bound value for the first node is calculated by considering, see, we want to assign job J1 to person A. The first value in the cell, that is 9. We want to assign job 1 to person A. So of the values. So temporarily the first column is placed after picking 9. Job 1 to person A, 9 is fixed. Next, so the result here, what value for the first node is 17. Lower bound value. Next, second node. For the second node, we want to assign job J2 to person. We need to pick J2 to person A. This 2 is fixed now, and this whole column is freezed for the time being, temporarily. It is freezed temporarily. For the remaining allocation, you are not going to pick any of the values from this column. So this column is temporarily freezed after selecting these 2 values. So those are my lower bound values for the lower bound value. Right. I want to assign job J2 to person A. Because 7 is the cost associated with when we want to assign job J3 person A. So this 7 I have written here. Then freeze this column temporarily. Don't select any of the values for the remaining rows. So this is fixed here, right? 7. the smallest value. You need to pick the smallest value from the remaining rows. You cannot select 3 because this column is totally freezed. This column is freezed. I have selected 7. After selecting 7, this column is freezed. From the remaining columns, you need to select the smallest value. Plus 4. So this is right. Plus 4 is 20. So LB value LB equal to 7 plus 5. The value is 20, right? Calculate the lower bound value for the next. Want to assign when I want to assign job J4 to person A, the cost associated with that is 8. So there is a value. My lower bound calculation. So this for the remaining assignments, for the remaining rows, you need to pick the smallest values. That's all. So I'm going to pick 3. I'm going to pick 4 right. I have calculated lower bound value for all these 4 nodes. For all these 4 nodes. By picking the smallest value from each of the row. And freezing a particular column for which I am calculating the lower bound value. So this is how the lower bound is to be calculated for the 4. This particular level will tell. You want to assign job J1 to person A, the total cost associated with that is 17. Right, 17. When you want to assign job J2 to person A, that LB value is 10. Job J3 to the same LB value and job J4 to A, it is giving me 18 as a lower bound value. So out of 4, I am going to pick the node for the next level exploring, the node with the smallest lower bound value, which is this second node, right? When I assign job J2 to person A, it has given me the lower bound value as 10, and this is the smallest lower bound value out of these 4 nodes. So I'm going to one of the job is fixed here. With job person A, because that is feasible solution here. So the cost associated with that is 2. So now after assigning job J2 to remove this column. That is not required now, because after first iteration, also after writing the first level node, I came to know that when I assign job J2 to person A, I'll get the least lower bound value. That's why so now only three jobs are available. Right, removed. Job J2 and person A is removed because already assignment has been done. Next, the remaining, there are three people and three jobs available. J1, job J3, job J4, and here person B, C, and D. So next level nodes, we are going to explore for person B. For person A, there were four options available. But for person B, now only three will be available. Three options will be available. So for person B, either you can assign job J1, or you can assign job J3, or job J4. So for person B, three options are available, and I'm going to write three nodes. Promising nodes. Those three are the non-promising nodes. Promising node is only one here, which has given me the least cost, lower bound value. So now, for person B, J3 is remained here, and J3, J4 are remained. Only three options remained for B. B, what is the lower bound value? I need three values here. Now, if I want to assign job J1 to person B, which is next, from the sixth, already I selected job J2 to person A, the cost also to be added. Cost also to be added here, because that is already fixed. So from this column, right, is 13, L B equal to calculated lower bound value when I want to assign. Next is 3, 2%, it is 3. Right. right? Equal to 14. Then lower bound value calculated, and the value is 14. So when I want to assign job J3 to person B, lower bound value is 14. What node number 3 says? Assign job J4 to person B. Two plus 7 plus 1 and then plus this 7. Keep it in mind, we are going to select this 7 because this column is string. As from the fourth row this is the smallest element, I cannot pick this because this column is temporarily freezed. I want to assign job J4 to person B. So already I have picked one value, and next value you cannot select here. So it is 2 plus 7 plus 1. Equal to 7. Check these three values, lower bound values. I want to fix now job, one of the job for person B. So which one is to be fixed here? The job which gives me the least cost for person B is to be fixed. So that is what is the cost? Assign job J1 to person B. The cost is 6. So 6. From the second row, 6 is so 6 is fixed because I assigned job J2 to person A and job J1 to person B. Next, remaining jobs are job J3 and J4, and two people are available, C and D. So now you need to available. For person C, job J3 is assigned. When for person C job J3 is assigned, only one option left out. J3 is assigned to person C and J4 is assigned to person D. Calculate for the last level node, we'll say it's not the lower bound value, it is the least cost value. Here available is for C3 I will assign, and for C I will assign job J4, and for D I will assign. When there are two people available and only two jobs remain, then I can assign job J3 to person C and job J4 to person D, or I can assign job J4 to person C and job J3 to person D interchangeably here. J3 to C, J4 to D, and the next available option is J4 to C and J4 to D. to D. Only two are available here. Now you need to calculate the least cost value for both the nodes. LC value, least cost value. So how to calculate here? From job to person A, row from the third row, see what is the third option, what is the option available here? J3 to C. And for D, J4 job assigned. It is 4. Then 6 plus 4, 10 plus 3, 13. So this is the least cost value for this node is 13. Next, for the next node, what it says is assign job J4 to person C. When I want to assign and J3 will be assigned to C. Nine. Add up these values here. Least cost calculated for this room. So out of these two, this has given me the least cost. Solution, but here means the least cost is the optimal, right? So it is satisfying as well as giving me the least cost. How it is satisfying constraint? See, and what is the cost when J3 is assigned? The cost is 1. J4 is assigned to person D. Cost is 4. So this is 4. These values here. Node value. So this is a job assignment problem solved by using branch and bound technique. So out of all these, see what we have done. In the 0th level, just we have picked the smallest value from each of the row and added those values. We calculated the sum, and sum is the lower bound value for 0th level node. So 0th level node will indicate that no job is to be assigned to any of the person. None of the job is assigned to the person here. But here, for person A, there are 4 choices available. So out of these 4, the second has given me the least cost value. So for person B, only 3 options are available. So those 3 options I return. Out of these 3 options, the first option has given me the least lower bound value. So that I picked for next level exploring. And here for C, J3 and J4, 2 options are available. Right, for C and D. For C and D person, 2 options are available. For C, J3 or J4, and for D, J4 or J3. But here this assignment has given me the least cost. That's why I will say that this is the optimal solution. So if you trace this tree, you will come to know that job assignment of job J4 to D, J3 to C, J1 to B, and J2 to A. come here. There is a node value, right? This is how job assignment problem is to be solved by using branch and bound technique, right? Next, we'll see traveling salesperson problem, TSP problem, using branch and bound. So we are looking at the least cost, lower bound value, and we'll see how this is to be solved. So consider a graph here, A, B, here it is C, D, and E. The cost is 8, it is 1, it is 5, here it is 3, 6, 7, 9, the cost is 4 here, it is 2 and 3. So this is the graph given. Traveling salesperson problem says that you need to start from a particular node. These nodes will indicate the cities of a tour. Traveling salesperson has to start with one city, for example A here, visit all the cities only once and come back to the original city where he started, that is A. Here we are calculating the least cost value. What is the least cost involved in taking the tour? So for that sake, again I need to draw state space tree and need to calculate the lower bound value, right? So right, need to calculate lower bound value for that. The total, the cost involved in traveling from one city to other city. From A to B city, if you want to travel, the total cost involved is 3. Right? Maybe it is cost in rupees, also the kilometer involved. Right? So here, we are targeting to calculate the least cost value. So for A, you need to find out the two least cost values. Need to find out two least cost values for A. From A, 3 and 1. From A to B is giving me 3, A to C is giving me 1. A to D is giving me 5 and A to E is giving me 8. These are the highest values. The two smallest values from A are 1 and 3. So for B also. From B, two least cost values are 3 and 6. So 3. From C, there are 4 paths. Out of these 4 paths, 1, 5, 4 and 2. Two least cost paths are, path values are 1 and 2. That is towards A and towards C. The costs are 1 and 2. two least cost values for D. For D, there are four paths available, towards B, towards A, towards C, and towards E, and the costs are 7, 6, 4, 3 respectively. But from D, two least cost paths are towards C and towards D with a cost of 4 and 3 respectively. So, for E, there are four paths again. One path is giving me 8, then 2, 3, and 9. 2 plus 3. And then this whole divided will give you LB value. Nine plus 4, 13. This is 16. 16 plus 7. What is the value of 16 plus 7? It is 23. 23 plus 5 is LB value. LB value for that is 14. For the next level, those four options are 4 options available. Here it is.